Wrapper classes are great for controlling content width and horizontal centering, but what happens if you get a design like this? How do you allow images to overflow the container on just one side and be responsive as well? Luckily, we have the mighty power of Grid at our fingertips. I'll start with some HTML and add a section element with a class of row. The row class will eventually become the Grid container, but more on that later. Next, I'll add two divs, adding one container for the text and one container for the image. The image container gets a modifier class, which I'll use to add in the background images. To start off, I'll apply the background images using the modifier classes. The new nesting feature in CSS makes this really simple. I love how legible this makes compound selectors. Alternatively, you can create the same selector like this. I'll give each container a minimum height to make the image visible. 50% of the viewport seems about right. I'll position the images in the center of the container and have them cover the entire surface. Now this is looking good, but on mobile views, I want the images to come before the text. To do this, I'll make the row div a Grid container by changing its display to Grid. Notice how the browser automatically flows the content into two rows, the order of which depends on the order in the HTML. This is pretty handy, but for mobile views, I want the images to live above the text. Luckily with Grid, it's really simple to place Grid items anywhere you want. I'll place the image container in the Grid row between lines 1 and 2. To prevent the text from touching the edges of the viewport, I add margin to the left and right sides of the text container. The mobile view looks great, but here's where the magic happens. At larger screens, I want the images to seemingly spill over the edge of their container. I also want to prevent the text from stretching too wide on the screen. To accomplish this, I'll create a 4-column grid. Inside the media query, I'll start by setting up the grid columns. For each column, I'll use the min-max function to set a range for the size. For the two outer columns, I'll set a minimum size of 1 rem and a maximum size of 1 fraction of the total available space. On smaller screens, they'll act like margins, shrinking to no smaller than 1 rem. As the viewport widens, they'll stretch up to 1 fraction of the total available space. The two inner columns will hold all the content, and my approach to their size is similar to the outer columns. Since I don't want the content to stretch any wider than 90 rem, I'll divide that by 2 and set the maximum size of each column to 45 rem. I'll set the minimum size to 0. Now it's just a matter of placing each container exactly where I want it. The text container will live in the grid column from lines 2 to 3, and the image container will live in the grid column from lines 3 till the end, or negative 1. Now, this is looking really good, but what happens if I want another row where the content is reversed? One with the image on the left and the text on the right. I can do this really easily by selecting the first child of the row div that is not the text container, and placing it in the grid column from lines 1 to 3. Then, I'll select the last child of the row div that is not the image container, and place it in the grid column from lines 3 to 4. With this, I've ensured that my content renders properly, regardless of its order in the HTML. And that's it. We've been able to get all of the features of a wrapper class without actually using a wrapper. Grid makes it super easy to build gorgeous layouts that are flexible and responsive with very little effort.